Johns Hopkins is dovetailing their guidelines with the guidelines from the states, as well as the guidelines federally. And so what we are trying to do is make sure that we monitor our healthcare workers appropriately based on their risk of exposure to Ebola, but also make sure that we protect our other healthcare workers as well as the community that we serve. At all of the Hopkins facilities, we are actively screening our patients. We do it at different times depending on how people are coming into the facility. And essentially, we're getting a travel history as well as looking for symptoms and then putting these people in isolation for further questioning to identify whether or not we need to move them to an emergency department where they can be further assessed or perhaps do another triage or triage them differently. People are not infectious before they develop symptoms. So as soon as they develop symptoms, what you want them to do is then call the appropriate authority. And then what you want to do is make sure that you transfer that patient into a receiving facility with their knowledge of what you suspect. And that way you assure that the EMS brings people in appropriately, as well as that we're ready to receive them. We put them immediately into an appropriate room, and our healthcare workers know what to expect, so they're gowned appropriately to make the assessment as needed for this individual. There are several tests that are used to diagnose Ebola. Currently, what we are doing is we would send the specimen over to the state laboratory. If it becomes positive, then they actually send it to the CDC for confirmation. The standard for Ebola testing is that you always have a secondary confirmation at a separate lab. That being said, the FDA has just released several tests that will be available in other laboratories. So I expect that there will be centers who will be able to test for Ebola, and then you could send it to the state laboratories for confirmation. Children will be monitored the same way that adults are monitored. The risk factors are the same, and so essentially what we want to do is make sure that we capture the information in a comparable fashion. Obviously, the data is probably coming from their parents, and so we'll be questioning the parents in many instances, or the guardians. We recognize that influenza and other respiratory viruses are going to be imminently here. And so the most important thing and most important message that we can give everybody is get your influenza vaccine. Everybody over the age of 6 months should be vaccinated. And remember to wash your hands, and wash your hands frequently so that you minimize the risk of getting a respiratory infection. The Ebola situation is dynamic, and watching the outbreak from the 30,000 foot view, many of us expect it to change over time and change quickly. And as everyone has seen, this is a rapidly evolving process. We need to make sure that we let people know that this is what we know today, and that as new guidance comes out, we are going to be making sure that we follow guidance as appropriate for the people we care for. So we need to be nimble and flexible and recognize that as we get more knowledgeable, there will be new guidance. One of the things that people talk about is the mortality associated with this virus. And I think it's important for everyone to recognize that Recently, with aggressive hydration, the use of antibiotics, and other very, very basic support care, the mortality has dropped dramatically. And for example, in some of the Ebola treatment units in Africa, they've dropped the mortality by 50% with simply hydrating people. And what we have seen in the United States, when people get in quickly and are rapidly treated, our mortality is under 15%. And so I think that it's really important that we let people know that this disease is going to be very different in the developed world, and that with early diagnosis, we can really impact the outcomes. What we want to do is just really convey the message that we have experts here that know how to treat infectious diseases. We have an environment where we know that there is no risk to our other patients, family members, visitors, and that we have done everything to make sure that we protect our healthcare workers. Okay.